That's the thing. Well, who's the main instigator of this? So yourself, is it?
The idea come from, have you seen a TV show that's called Fleabag?
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet, but yeah.
Have anyone seen that Fleabag on the television?
No.
Well, it's a lady, and she has a cafe. And again, everyone's sitting in the cafe just playing with the phones, no one's actually social reacting anymore. And I'm old enough to remember when people actually spoke. You know what I mean? So what's happened is, on this Fleabag, she introduced me called Chatty Wednesday. Where when he walks into the shop, you literally had to just go in and go, "Hello, I'm Steve, what's your name? What are you doing today?" We're going back to 1980 where people actually spoke. Instead of sitting there, and I'm not using my phone, but I will give this up.
That's close.
Doing that. They just drive you mad. To me, it drives me mad. And more people are doing it. Then the pubs and Chester started doing it as well. So we just thought, let's do it. Because this is really quiet, by the way. For us at the moment.
Normally it's swamp.
Yeah.
Of course. So,
then I had young, no disrespect to young people like you, you can't speak anymore, can you? Your thumbs are basically worn out.
No, you're right.
So all I did was, I just thought, one day, I sat here one day, and I looked around the shop, and there were six young lads doing this. No one was speaking. And I went, I won't swear, do me a favour, put your phones away, let's all talk again. And then I'll throw controversial comments in, what do you think about Michael Jackson? And that's it, then everyone goes off on one, don't they? And that's all it was, but is that Fleabag when I seen it on that?
Yeah.
The Chatty Wednesday, I thought to myself, what a good idea that is to have a Chatty Wednesday, where people are going to actually speak again. So, it was brilliant. To be fair, apart from a couple of negative comments, people taking it out of context, because you know, when you come in this shop, it's a laugh.
Yeah,
not on serious. We don't try.
I've been here before, and you had Santa visiting with autistic
kids. Well, we have Santa, that's right. Yeah. We try and do things for the community if we can. And that's ideal. So yeah, Santa is still going strong, by the way.
Brilliant.
Comes every year for us.
I've been very good this year as well. So
oh, I'll tell them.
They'll get a visit. Yeah.
We have Santa cam up there. That's what we tell the children.
Brilliant.
But no, it's just a case of, I hope more places just start doing this where people talk again.
There's enough to talk about at the moment, isn't there?
Well, we were in.
As long as it's not Brexit.
As long as it's not Brexit, yeah. Are you serious?
No political. No political.
Happy days.
It shouldn't exist, huh? October the 31st now, I believe, isn't it? Go and get your lollipop, darling, in the corner for being a good girl. There you go. Our secretary will show you where they are. You show me where they are, thank you. We were out one Sunday having a pint, which we all bought, and had a few squads once every third month. And we were in Dr. Pepper's in Liverpool. And there was two really, really lovely girls in the bar getting a drink, and we sat down with their two boyfriends. And the four of them sat there, and I observed for an hour. I thought I was looking at the lovely girls. No one spoke. For 1 hour, we sat there doing this.
Texting each other.
There was a live band on. They were brilliant. The atmosphere was booming. And four people for an hour like that. You might as well stay there, mate. You may as well just go home. Saved themselves £4, £5 a pint. And done this with the phones. But,
like I said,
is my phone going?
No. Let's see this.
It's a spam caller.
I'm not sure if I can use that bit.
Hey, that was on cue, wasn't it? That was actually on cue.
I did, I might have to cut it off. So, how did your forfeits come about then?
The forfeits again with a bit of a laugh, purely because we have the music channel on in here, of the 1980s.
Yeah.
Obviously what we're trying to replicate. It was just a case of, our first thought was we were going to do Karaoke Friday, where we were going to get a bowl of curry in here. You could come and get your hair cut and have a curry. We were going to call it Karaoke and have a song.
Why not?
And that's what we first thought of.
What confuses me though is people are scared to do karaoke, but when you're drunk, you do it anyway.
Well, I'll do it anytime, doesn't what you mean?
I'll sing down the street when I'm drunk, I don't care.
But it was just a case of the forfeits come. What we said about, which we should have told you, is any money that's donated via double haircuts is purely for local charity, autistic children.
Brilliant.
So we're not making any money out of it, you know what I mean? It's just a case of we'll give the money to autistic children.
It's a good cause,
eh? So that's so people think it's not a money made. We're busy enough, we don't need more business. But we can make a little bit
more. I was going to say that.
Probably come here for the entertainment as well, then.
I think that's mostly it, because we're shit about it. So
looks all right, how's your haircut?
Well, one of my mates, he said, can he come here just to do a karaoke song, not get his haircut?
Very welcome. Well. Feedback and signs, as requested.
Yep, spot on.
There you go, young man.
You don't fancy a karaoke yourself, then?
No. You're not going to do a song for it?
Have you got any beers in there, maybe?
Well, we have, but we can't give them because we're not a licensed premises.
Yeah. just that.
Yeah. Thank you very much. You're the star.
Have you got a five on me?
Have I got a five on me?
Yeah, I was going to say, if you've got a five, take a five out of that and put it in charity.
Oh, cheers, matey. Well, put that there in there. Right, so that's for you. That's for me and that's for the charity box. Thank you very much. Very kind.
Yeah, guys.
See you later.
I'll go in the charity box.